Thelonious, he was so weird. He wandered the twilight streets of Harlem in winter with no hat on his hair, sweating, blowing fog. In his head, he heard it all ringing. Often he heard whole choruses by Lester, or Bird, or Dizzy, or Bags. There was a strange English kid hanging around Mittens who stumbled along the sidewalk hearing Lester in his head. Hours of hundreds of developing choruses in regular beat all day, so in the subway no dissonance could crash against unalterable choruses and implacable bars erected in mind's foundation jazz. Now the tune they were playing was All the Things You Are. They slowed it down and dragged behind it at half-tempo dinosaur proportions, changed the placing of the note in the middle of the harmony to an outer, more precarious position, where also its sense of not belonging was enhanced by the general atonality produced with everyone exteriorizing the tune's harmony. The clonk of the millennial piano like anvils in Petrograd. "Blow," said Diz. Jolly Parker came in for solo with a squeaky, innocent cry. Monk punched, anguished, nub fingers crawling at the keyboard to tear up foundations and guts of jazz from the big master box. To make Charlie Parker hear his cry and sigh, to jar the orchestra into vibrations, to elicit gloom from the doom of the black piano. He stared down wild-eyed at his keys like a matador at the bull's head. Groan, drunken figures shaded in the weaving background, tottering. The boys didn't care, because on cold corners they stood, three backs to one another, facing all the winds, bent, lips don't care, miserable, cold, and broke, waiting like witch doctors, saying, "Everything belongs to me because I am poor." Like 12th century monks high in winter belfries of the Gothic organ, they wild-eyed were listening to their own wild sound, which was heralding a new age of music that would eventually require symphonies, schools, centuries of technique, declines and falls of master ripe styles, the Dixieland of Louis Armstrong 16 in New Orleans and the Big Pops Forest, Jim in the white shirt wailing at a big scarred bass in raunchy, nongry New Orleans, on South Rampart Street, famous for parades, and Old Perdido Street. All that was mud in the river, Mississippi, pasts of 1910 gold rings, derby hats of workers. Soon enough it would leap and fill the gay 20s like champagne in a glass, pop, and crawl up to the 30s with tired, rooty valleys lamenting what Louis had laughed in a 20s transoceanic jazz. Sick and tired early Ethel Merman's, and old beat bedsprings creaking in that stormy weather blues when people lay in bed all day and moaned and had it good.
"5 months, 2 weeks, 2 days, my loving baby's been gone. 5 months, 2 weeks, 2 days, my loving baby's been gone. If you see my baby, please send her home for me. Hurry, oh, oh, baby. 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 Hurry, oh, oh, baby.
The world of the United States was tired of being poor and low and wounding the line. Swing erupted as the Depression began to crack. It was the year marijuana was made illegal, 1937. Young teenagers took to the first restraint, the second, the third. Some still wandered on hobo trains.
Hurry on, 5 months, 2 weeks, 2 days. Hurry on, 5 months, 2 weeks, 2 days. me home.
Lost boys of the 30s numbered in the hundreds of thousands. Salvation armies put up full houses every night, and some were 10 years old.
Try to think that love's not around. Still, it's uncomfortably near. My old heart ain't gaining no ground because my angel eyes ain't here. Angel eyes that old devil sent, they glow unbearably bright. Need I say that my love's misspent, misspent with angel eyes tonight. So drink up all you people, order anything you see. Have fun, you happy people, the drink and a laugh's on me. Pardon me, but I've gotta run. The fact's uncommonly clear. I gotta find who's now the number one and why my angel eyes ain't here.
Teenagers, alienated from their parents who have suddenly returned to work and for good to get rid of that damn old mud of the river and tear the rose vine off the porch and paint the porch white and cut the trees down and castrate the hedges, burn the leaves, build a wire fence, get up an antenna, listen.
So drink up all you people and order anything you see. The drinks and the laughs are on me. Pardon me, but I gotta run. The fact's uncommonly clear. I gotta find who's now the number one and why my angel eyes ain't here. Excuse me while I disappear. Gotta find my angel eyes.
The alienated teenager in the 20th century, finally ripe, gone wild, modern, to be rich and prosperous, no more just around the corner, became the hepcat, the jitterbug, and smoked the new law weed.